So what's going on, guys?
Well, you know what the real tea is? I'm going to spill this tea right here. We don't remember what happens because we shot this back in February into March, and I can't tell you what happens because I don't remember. You know, when you're in it and you're doing it, you can remember the specifics of it. And then us,
so
just
what,
like
no
you, we have to watch.
Sex scenes, no big sloppy kisses.
I mean,
really memorable.
Not that I remember. I'll have to ask the young ones on that. They're the ones that get the sloppy wet kisses and the roll arounds. I wish that there was a moment like that, because really, it's a little bit more chaotic for every show. It's not just our show that happens at the end. But you know, you're rolling along. Maybe you've gotten three or four scripts that are in the hopper and that are approved, and then maybe somebody gets sick, and then maybe you're a little bit late on one, and then all of a sudden you're pushing a snowball up a mountain to get pages done before you shoot them the next day. And so we were there at the end, we were getting rewrites and pages at the last minute, and so literally it was coming fast and furious. And while you prepare and you try to do the material as best as you can, it's almost like you're in a panic because everybody's got to get this done and we only have a certain amount of time. So it's really a blur. It's really a blur. But it was amazing. And everybody was so heightened emotionally that, you know, it was just a really amazing time all the way around.
A lot of tears on the set.
Yeah, a lot of tears. And also, I think, like, when we started, after the holiday break, when we started back in January, I personally started going up to people and sitting with, you know, I always sit with someone different at lunch, but like really going up to people and saying, you know, thanks so much for being here, and you know, I want you to know that, you know, you brightened my day when I did this. So I tried to have as many small moments with people as possible, so it wasn't like, you know, high school, see you later, throw the papers, and like, you know, not letting everybody know that, you know, you cared about them for the last six seasons. Was that a spoiler? We'll have to see. I'm going to pass on that question because I don't know for sure. But yeah, I mean, we can say that there are some people that come back, and you know, and I think that was a really beautiful thing. I mean, Colton says that it's all his fault that everybody's coming back, apparently, that he pushed all the buttons on everyone. But, you know, that I think also was a little bit of the Jeff Davis magic of really not killing everybody off. You know what I mean? Like, when they left, it wasn't necessarily a huge, vengeful, horrible death scene where, you know, die, 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 die. It's, you know, people coming back, and so that'll be a lot of fun. Yeah, I mean, I think it's like, you know, it's the enemy within kind of thing, and I think it's one of those things that in Supernatural you fear, right? The environment turning against you. You know, it's interesting that you would think that maybe that would be the first thing to happen, right? Like, it's taken six seasons for the people of Beacon Hills to know what's up, you know? There's been bodies piling up in that hospital for a long time. You think someone at that police station would be like, wait a minute, we need to, like, investigate a little bit more.
Just a little bit.
Just a little bit. And, like, nobody knows. Like, in the neighborhoods, people are out wolfing around. Nobody has ever seen it, you know? So, but it's interesting that it's coming at the end. And I think, actually, you know, even though it's a supernatural show, I think the humans on our show could be very powerful. I think so, and there are certain steps that happen with her that I think she gets even more empowered over the last 10 episodes of the show. Somebody needed to make a move.
I know.
And if you think about it, really, I mean, okay, so, you know, we have, you know, if you think about, like, Mama McCall has been, like, dalliance with four men on the show. I've had more boyfriends than everyone. I have had more action than everyone. You know, I think, you know, maybe subconsciously, because I was looking for those moments as well, but I think he's kind of growing up, you know, so those sweet moments aren't so sweet anymore because they're adult moments and they're more real and they're more grounded. And I'm, you know, you have to, I feel like I'm a step parent, so I feel like you know, at one point you turn around and you look at your child and you realize that they're not a child anymore. And if you respect your child, you deal with them differently. Because how else are you going to know everything that you poured into them stuck? If you're coddling them and not letting them grow, then you'll never know all those beautiful ingredients. And then you stuck them in the oven and you pulled out a fully baked cake. Like, what does that cake look like? And I think that's what we get this season coming up. I mean, I really have to think about that. They're all really special to me. I mean, I remember, you know, Tyler is almost there every single day. He's been there every single day for almost 7 years when you count, like, when we did the pilot. So I'm sure his days kind of meld together a little bit more than mine. I'm there maybe once or twice every couple of weeks. So for me, driving into set, seeing what color scrubs, it's not all a blur, really. Yeah, all those days are really, really special. Well, I hope I don't have to say goodbye. I hope that everybody sticks around for everybody's upcoming projects and wonderful things. You know, I mean, look, Daniel's on Fear of the Walking Dead. So, you know, Charlie and Max, they're involved with producing stuff, writing, creating, and producing stuff. Holland's on a new show. You know what I mean? Shelley's been in a couple of things. Tyler, obviously, with, you know, Jane the Virgin. And so, you know, I hope that we don't have to say goodbye. I hope it's just like, what's next? What's next for everybody? You know, in 6A, I got to work more with Ryan Kelly, and that was fun. We had a couple of scenes together there at the end, and so that was a lot of fun. But other than him, I can't think of anybody off the top of my head. Maybe. Maybe not. Okay. Thanks for your questions, you guys.
Thank you.